Hi everyone, my name is Maxime Chagnot. I'm a Catia consultant working for PLM technology in Norway, and today it's a special Design Fast episode for Easter. I'm going to perform a live demonstration on 3D experience release 19x on the cloud, and in order to show you how we can easily design an Easter egg. Okay, follow me. I will first create a 2D part called Easter egg. I want to be sure that I mean generative shape design for shape. Okay, as you can see, I don't see the tree plane. It means that I'm in the wrong view mode. I will go in shading with edges and I will start by making a sketch. And the fastest way I found to create an egg quickly is to mix a circle and an ellipse. Okay, like that, great. Okay, so as you can see at the beginning, it does not look good for an egg, but I'm just going to trim some parts, and I use the quick trim button, and it looks already a bit better. Okay. Oh, as you can see, I'm in part design, so there is no problem. I can just create a geometrical set and move my sketch into that. And well, we are going to make a revolution of that egg. So the first thing I would like to do is to split this line or curve, you call it as you want. Yeah, in both. And just keep one side there. But as you can see, the curve of this egg is not very smooth. And one way to look at it would be to go to review and just do a quick porcupine analysis to see that this is not nice. This is not even connected in curvature. So, well, I'm going to delete that. And I will use a very nice feature in generative shape design that is called curve smooth. Basically, will smooth my point connection here. And curvature would be nice. Okay, so I've been testing it a bit already. So I think we can try with 1 millimeter and click the preview. It looks not that bad. And of course, there is no problem to modify that. 2 millimeter, 3 millimeter. I mean, that is up to you. I think I will just keep 1 millimeter or 2 millimeter. Great. It looks good to me. We can, of course, do another porcupine analysis to look at our egg shape, and now it looks very much cleaner. Okay, I can just hide that for the moment. Now what we want to do is, of course, to revolve this curve here around the set axis. So set axis, great. And we want to have 360 degrees, and of course you can hide the curve smooth because we don't need any more. Okay, looks good to me so far. And the reason of this video today is to demonstrate actually the feature disconnect that is new in 19x. I will make in one sketch only, I really mean only one sketch, several splines. And you decide the shape, but I want just a lot of spline. I mean, let's try to keep it to 5 or 6. Like that. Okay, 4, let's do maybe 1 more. Excellent. And you can see here I'm in only one sketch here. I will exit that sketch. And I will select the feature projection because you want to project this line to your shape here. So as you can see, support is the revolute feature I had. And you don't want to have the nearest solution because it's going to give you only one line. So you remove that option, and of course you select, always select direction because the result is much better. And in that case here would be the X axis, X component. Preview. And great, this is exactly what you want, but this time you want to keep all the sub elements. And it's a bit messy here, just don't worry, I'm just going to hide my sketch. And you see here that basically the line are projected on the egg. and we want to split the egg in several patch, if you see. And for doing so, you go to transform, and under the split and trim, you have a disconnect feature that is pretty nice. Basically, you're going to say, I want to disconnect the egg with the project. And that's it. You can hide the project because we don't need it anymore, but here you can see that you have several patches. Well, to continue a bit in that way, I just want to make an extract of each of these patches, because I feel it's always a bit better to have an extract to just have each patch together. I will go to just under boundary, you have extract feature here. And very important to select the small bag here, because you want to select several patches. This one, this one, this one, this one, this one, and this one. How it look like? We can just make sure that if I hide the one, yeah, okay. You can see that if I hide some of them, we can see that it's disconnected patches. Okay, and now we go back to our part body, because now I want to make a solid out of that shape. We can switch on part design. And what am I going to do? Very simple. I'm going to just use the feature thick surface. And you select your extract here and reverse direction. Let's make it 0.5 millimeter. And a nice way to do it would be maybe to continue doing that, but increasing a bit, 1 millimeter here in that case. And we continue that way. You want to reverse the direction, 0.5. You have many ways of doing it. I just wanted to do it that way for the video. 1 millimeter, of course, reverse direction. We continue, 0.5, reverse direction. And the last one here would be, 1 millimeter. Okay, we can just hide our geometrical set for the moment. Okay, looks nice. Of course, it could be nice to add some fillet to that egg, and no problem for doing that. I can just go to refine and use the feature auto fillet and just say that, well, I just want all my fillets at 0.25. I'm not sure if it will work, but we'll see. Preview. Of course, it takes some time for the software to update. Looks well, even if you have a small error message, it looks okay to me. Well, it was not an error message, but more like an alert message. But in worst case, we can always change the value of the fillet. Well, I liked Catia because it always works. Let's see if this fillet is nice at least. It looks pretty good to me. Excellent. And well, now it's only the furnishing left. We can just add some picture. You can always go back to this view here. It's a bit nicer because they remove all the plane, etc. And something that few people know is that if you go to display and you go to object properties, you have this nice painter that was not available before. And here you can directly apply color, or you can also apply texture, and that will also, well, give a nice color to that egg. And of course, you have many different things, but I just want to go to painting because they are pretty nice color. And here's the funny part. You can just, yeah, you select your face basically, and you can put some blue color and I don't know, just feel free to do the same and try the color you would like to have. Put some, maybe, yeah, like that. And what about to finish with pink in the bottom? Yeah, not too bad, but now I need to, of course, do the fillet. So feel free to pick up the color you like and just make, oh, OK, Okay, I can continue. This is only the funny part, to be honest. Okay. Oh, like pink. Some red. Yeah, like a green apple. Okay, looks pretty good. Then you have your egg. And of course, we are in Catia, so it's no problem for dating the line. So the way to do it would be to go back to your sketch here. And of course it's hidden for the moment, but yeah, you can with no problem modify a bit the curvature of your area. So if I modify some of them and exit, well, you have to know that the software needs to update the whole design, of course, because we have made disconnect, the extract, and then the thick surface, and of course, finally, the fillet. But yeah, here it is. And that's the real power of Catia. So thank you very much for watching the video. Do not hesitate to follow us on the YouTube, on the PLM YouTube channel. Visit our website, www.plmtechnology.com. And I just wish you a happy Easter. Thank you very much. Goodbye.